In 1975 and 1976, Chevy Chase single-handedly established the indelible comedic caricature of President Gerald Ford as an unending physical risk, a man who might fall down or trip over something at any moment. Last winter, Saturday Night Live established a meme of a media in the tank for Barack Obama, which promptly begat a conversion of the Clinton campaign into a serious version of that same martyrdom, and has, in a kind of political grandchild, the nonstop whining of the McCain campaign about media bias, even though most of that seems to benefit its own candidate. Our number one story in the countdown, public ridicule as a critical political component. And here it comes again with what is reportedly week two of a seven-week cameo of Tina Fey as Sarah Palin. Some of her lights-out impression did not even require any new material.
Every American I'm speaking with, we're ill.
Like every American I'm speaking with, we are ill.
But ultimately, what the bailout does is help those who are concerned about the health care reform that is needed.
But ultimately, what the bailout does is help those that are concerned about the health care reform that is needed to help shore up our economy.
It's got to be all about job creation.
It's got to be all about job creation, too.
To shoring up our economy and putting it back on the right track.
Also to shoring up our economy and putting Fannie and Freddie back on the right track.
So health care reform and reducing taxes.
And so health care reform and reducing taxes.
And reining in spending.
And reining in spending.
But this was hardly just parroting, as the rest of us fiddled around with analogies to minor birds and talking caribou Barbie dolls. Seth Meyers and the writers hit the analogy right on the head.
Katie, I'd like to use one of my lifelines.
I'm sorry?
I want to phone a friend.
Let's turn now to Emily Heil, who writes the Heard on the Hill column for Roll Call, the newspaper of record for Capitol Hill. Thanks for your time tonight, Emily.
Glad to be here, Keith.
Satire is one thing, but as big a laugh as anything else in that sketch was the word-for-word from Governor Palin's interview with Katie Couric. Is that the lowest it can get for a politician when your serious words, with almost no embellishment, bring back cascades of laughter?
You know, Keith, I am not going to ever say that anything is the lowest it can get for a politician, because I think you and I both know that there is no limit to how low that bar can go. But honestly, it is interesting and very significant when you don't even have to write punchlines, when the candidate writes them him or herself. I think it really reminded me of George H.W. Bush. You remember Dana Carvey using all those great lines that were actually mined from actual presidential speeches. You know, read my lips. You know, those kind of things. And they really rang so true because they actually came from the candidate's mouth. And I think, you know, with Sarah Palin, the danger is even greater, because most of the time when you see a satiric version of a political figure, you have the real version to compare it to. In this case, we don't. And so in the same way that sort of Dana Carvey sort of owned the persona of George H.W. Bush, it seems that it's easier for Tina Fey to sort of own the persona of Sarah Palin, at least for a little while, until we actually see the real Sarah Palin.
If. When the SNL skit was in her favor, Senator Clinton tried to pick up the ball and run with it. She referenced that that whole in the tank for Obama, get him another cushion thing in an actual debate. It went over like a lead balloon. Is there anything that the governor can do with this? Can she try to pick it up? Can she have fun with it? Go on the show, embrace this somehow?
Well, you know, I'm really not in the business of giving advice, but I think there would be probably a big upside to her sort of going along with the joke. It's so much better, I think, from a public perspective, to be in on the joke and not to be sort of the butt of it. And you see John McCain doing this to some extent. You know, he makes old man jokes every now and then to sort of blunt the impact of the jokes that are inevitably going to be made about him. So it's sort of that way of giving a wink and a nod and sort of owning that joke, as opposed to just being the sort of clueless victim of it. So, you know, maybe we'll see, you know, the real Sarah Palin appearing alongside Tina Fey. It might be a smart thing for her to feel like she's in on the joke instead of just the butt.
Is it always a bad thing to have this happen? Because obviously the Gerry Ford reference, while they were harpooning him every week, he went from 33 points down to 31 points at the end against Carter. Is there some way this could work, even a sympathy measure for Governor Palin?
Well, you know, that's a great point, Keith. It very well might. And it depends on the audience. I think for some people, you know, being the butt of a joke from the, you know, elite liberal Manhattan folks, maybe, you know, that's sort of a badge of honor as opposed to being a bad thing. People might rush to her defense, particularly if she does better than, you know, a lot of people are expecting her to in the debate. So this may be actually a badge of honor and not a bad thing. People might actually sympathize.
Yeah, at this rate, the way expectations are going for Thursday night, if she's still standing at the end of 90 minutes, she will have done better than people expect. Emily Heil, a columnist for Roll Call. Thank you, Emily.
Glad to be here, Keith.
That's Countdown for this, the 1,979th day since the declaration of mission accomplished in Iraq. I'm Keith Olbermann. Good night and good luck.